Hi everyone, I hope you're all well. Welcome back to the channel. Today we are in Assetto Corsa Competizione again with the release of the Emil Frey Jaguar G3 at Zolder. So I've racked up another 16 cars for a 15-minute race. We're starting 8th on the grid. The Jaguar itself, or any Jaguar, holds a pretty special place in my heart, so I'll go into that in a little bit, but let's see how we go. I don't know if there's been any updates to the AI for this release. I don't know if their aggression settings actually mean anything at the moment. As you've probably seen from my last videos, it doesn't matter what I sort of set them to, they're extremely aggressive. And they appear to weigh about 10 tonnes, so coming into contact with them is basically race ending. Anyway, let's get it underway. So, try and stay out of trouble. Coming into turn two. I feel you've got to be quite delicate with the Jag. It responds well to gentle inputs and not being manhandled around corners. And the Zolder layout's pretty cool too. I don't think I've ever actually raced a Zolder before. I like some of the technical corners and the elevation changes too. That's pretty good. Gets the car on a little bit of balance. So yeah, the Jag feels nice. It can be a touch oversteery. You've got to be, as I said, you've got to be pretty delicate with it. So yeah, Jag holds a pretty special place in my heart. My dad worked for Jaguar for 42 years. And I've got extremely fond memories of him taking my brother and I to see things like the XJR9 before it took place one and two at Le Mans. And it also took us to see the XJ220 prototype as well. So any chance I get to actually race the driver Jag in the sim, I'll take it any day. A little bit wide there. I'm tending to just let this Jag coast around some of these corners. Seems to respond quite well to it. But it's I feel like over the last few updates there's definitely been some improvements to ACC, but I think there needs to be a fair bit more work on the AI. And I'm sure they're aware of that. The AI's all over the place. Come on. Having said that though, I feel like this race is going better than my other races so far. I'm trying to go down the inside here, so I'll probably get taken out. Yep. Jag appears to have some pretty nice pace too. I haven't messed around a huge amount with this setup, I've just... overshot that, that's a nightmare. Two cars passed, okay. So we went from 8th to 6th to 5th to 7th in the space of two laps. Even though Zolder, I think Zolder's a pretty cool technical circuit, but I wouldn't say it's a very exciting circuit to race on. Lando's running on me. competitive with the AI through there, I think. So yeah, I'm obviously a little bit biased towards the Jag, but I actually like it. I like the way it feels. I like the way it drives, even though I'm not being super competitive with these cars right now. I actually like it. I like to hear people's thoughts about it, if you've got any. I love the sound, externally it's great, when you watch a replay it sounds awesome. But it's definitely a car that responds well to gentle creation, not just being thrown around. I think I might try and record the external replay for this video and stick it up in the corner. It's still all pretty closely packed here. Doesn't seem to be one car that's standing out much quicker than the rest. It's looking pretty well balanced. Ooh, stepped out a little bit there. Out there as well. Oh, careful on the curve. That was better. A little bit of ground there. This is going to be messy, I think. Yep, there it goes. Oh, made up some spots then. Out of it, your Ferrari. Well, that worked in our favour. Let's see if I can capitalise.
You're halfway through, not over yet.
Oh, gone deep. Come on, come on, come on. So yeah, setup wise, just all I've done is altered the rear toe, set it as close as possible to zero, or actually let's set it to zero, and left the camber as it is in the aggressive setup, increased the wing, the rear wing, to the max. I've seen a few setups online, but they all appear to be set up for hot lapping really, and probably not the best for racing. They're pretty loose at the rear. That's better. Whew. Isn't too bad, but we made it visible down the road. I love this part of the track. Very rewarding if you get it right, but a nightmare if you get it wrong. Pretty well through there. Gotta watch that rise because the car's off balance. Again, a little bit too deep. Lost a bit of time. Coming up to the last chicane, leading onto the next lap. Still unsure about the right gear to be in for that chicane. Having said that though, I've only had a couple of races so far. a little bit of brake, let it coast around there, back on. It's pretty obvious how well that responded there to just being gently driven around the corner and scrambling right up. Definitely wants to step out in first and second, that's for sure. I don't know if there have been any other changes in this release other than the car on track. You would think so, but there's definitely a slightly different feel to the sim now, I think. Maybe a little bit more, now I'm driving a little bit more, a little bit more complete. If that makes sense, but it doesn't feel as on edge as it did in previous builds. I still think we made up a little bit of ground, but I'm definitely down on my last lap, that's for sure. Ooh. I'll keep it together. Definitely find yourself using pretty much all of the track in the Zolder. I keep messing up that hairpin, don't I? I might need to go just a little bit early next time. A little bit better, made some time from that last corner. That was a bit better too, I think. Oof. All right to the edge. Yeah, so I've got to say I'm pretty impressed with this car on this track. I mean, it's a great mix, great combination. It's actually becoming fun to drive as a sim. Sorry. Right, let's concentrate and see if we can actually make some ground up here. On the gas. Made up a little bit to that corner. I that hard. Get out of it. Oh,
right,
wow.
The leader is on the final lap. Give it a final push.
Wow. Really lost it there. So we've got one lap to go. That's it, session over. And we're on the podium. Wow. Well, not bad. I don't think that was due to any skill of my own. I think it's due to that accident. But anyway, I'll take a podium. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed that. That is Beta 5 for ACC, and that was the Emil Frey Jaguar G3. If you did enjoy, give it a like, subscribe, and hit the bell, and I'll be sure to upload more content soon. Thanks, guys. Bye.